What's going on, everyone? Thanks for tuning in. Today's video is going to be another product review. It's going to be on the Tyrant Designs CNC Glock Gen 5 trigger. This was sent out to me by Tyrant Designs. I did reach out to them and they were kind enough to send out this trigger shoe for me to do a review. If you guys want to check them out, their website is tyrantcnc.com. They make a whole bunch of different parts for Glocks, trigger shoes as you see here. And then they make slide stop releases, mag releases, magazine extensions, etc. Check them out. So without further ado, let's jump down below and we'll take a closer look at this trigger shoe. Alright, so I brought you guys in a little closer to see what comes in the packaging. Don't mind my finger here, I did cut my finger. I don't know on what, but it is what it is. Anyways, again, Glock trigger shoe made by Tyrant Designs. In the packaging, basically you're just going to get the trigger shoe itself and a little Allen wrench. Reason being is because when you attach the trigger shoe to the trigger bar, there's a little Allen screw right here that you gotta back out and put it in. Again, this is the Tyrant CNC I.T.T.S, which stands for Improved Tyrant Trigger System for the Glock Gen 5. They do make Gen 3 and 4, but this one specifically is for the Gen 5. Everything is nice and machined. It does have the safety shoe here as well. I believe there's a 30% spring in here, which will help aid in a trigger reset. The screws here are all stainless steel. This one here is gold, as you can see. They make them in different colors as well. There's black, red, and some other different colors. Now this here is the stock Glock trigger shoe. Curved trigger shoe. And a lot of people don't like this trigger safety here because it doesn't depress all the way. So when you're shooting, this actually protrudes a little bit and it leaves a little indent in your finger after a while. Shooting in that is a little uncomfortable for some shooters. I don't mind it too much, but this here will be going inside the Glock here. I won't be showing an install video of this. There's other videos online that you guys can check out. So this trigger shoe is not supposed to reduce any spring weights or anything like that. It's just a flat trigger shoe for a better feel when you're shooting in your pistol. And the 30% spring for a better reset. So we're going to get it installed. We're going to go outside, take a few shots, and come back and give my final thoughts. Alright, hopefully you guys can see this, but I did get the trigger shoe installed. Pretty simple. You just take the gun apart, take out the trigger bar, punch out the pin that's holding in the old trigger shoe, screw this one back in, you're ready to go. It is clear, so you're still going to have the same Glock mushiness, if that's what you want to call it. And then after that, the wall, break, reset, break. Feels a lot better now with the flat trigger shoe, honestly. So the trigger safety bar here doesn't go all the way in. There's probably 10% of it left, which is a lot less than a standard Glock trigger. So we're gonna put some rounds through and see how it is. Gives a more consistent placement on the trigger shoe here. Wall, break, reset. Now the 30%, it does kick your finger out a little bit more. I don't know if I like that. Just a little more range time with this and I'll figure if I will, but let's put some more rounds through this guy. So far, this trigger is pretty good. I like it. I like the flatness of it. The safety bar does go in a lot farther than the stock Glock trigger. The design is nice, and it is aluminum. I'm just wondering how many shots before this Allen screw comes out, if it does, or if any. But let's put a few more rounds through it. Follow-up shots with this trigger is really fast. I don't know if it's just a mind game, but this trigger, for $75, you can't beat it. Really like it. Again, check them out, tyrantcnc.com. So far, everything's been really good about this trigger. The Allen screw has not backed out yet. Show you guys one more time here. Take up, break, reset. I saw there, kicks it out a little bit, and it's gonna hit the wall again. Good to go. Gonna take about 5 more shots here at 30 yards, and then we'll go back inside and give them final thoughts on this trigger. Alright, we're back up top. What are my thoughts on this Tyrant CNC trigger? Everything seems to be machined really nice. I like the flat face trigger shoe. It gives you a more consistent pull when you're pulling on the trigger. Like I mentioned before, it's not going to lessen the pull weight. It's just going to have a different feel based on the flat trigger here. And then with the safety blade here, it's going to depress inside the trigger shoe just a little bit more than the stock Glock trigger. So that's going to be a plus. Some other things I like about this trigger shoe is the fit and finish is really good. There's really no sharp edges on there. From the looks of it, it looks like it's sharp, but once you put your finger in it, everything is really smooth. I do like that it uses an Allen screw instead of a pin, so in case you ever want to change this out, for whatever reason, you can just unscrew that little Allen screw. Only time will tell if this here is going to back out. Put some blue Loctite on that Allen screwing and you guys will be fine. I do like that it's made out of aluminum and not polymer, so it's going to be a lot sturdier. The 30% spring in here does work really well. It does kick your finger out just a little bit more after the reset, so you can get back on that wall just a lot quicker. If you're in the market for a trigger shoe, I'd definitely check out Tyrant CNC. And if you're on the fence about switching out trigger bar, springs, etc., check out this trigger shoe because all the safety mechanisms are still going to work. You're just replacing the shoe itself. The only thing I can see failing maybe, if it ever was to, is this blade here, but I don't think it ever will, just because this spring is a little bit more stout than the Glock spring. But that's all I have for you guys. Any questions, leave in the comment section below. I'll try my best to answer them. Again, just want to say thanks to Tyrant CNC for sending this out for me to do a review. Really appreciate that. Check them out. Until next time, be safe, everyone.